Hi everyone and welcome. Today I have a pretty special motherboard to share with you. It is a Super Socket 7 board with a SIS540 chipset. Yes, you heard right, it is a 540, not the 530. As far as I know, this is the last chipset released for Super Socket 7, a whole year after popular chipsets like the SIS530, the ALI Aladdin 5, and the VIA Apollo MVP4, and even a few days after the ALI Aladdin 7. To put the release date into perspective, the 30th of November 1999 is about 6 months after the first Athlons were released, and about the same time as the Pluto Core Athlons up to 750 MHz. 4 months later, in March 2000, we had the first Athlons at 1 GHz. This seems to be very late in the game for Super Socket 7, but strangely enough, K62 chips are still being released even throughout the year 2000. With the K62 at 550 MHz being released in February 2000, and mobile versions like the K62 Plus at 550 even later that year in June. The SIS540 is heavily based on the SIS630 for Socket 370, and as such, it includes a pretty powerful integrated graphics core based on SIS301. It includes an IDE controller with Ultra 66 support, and it also has native support for 133 MHz SD-RAM. The maximum supported FSB is listed at 100 MHz, not 133. But one might wonder whether this is because, unlike Socket 37 CPUs, there are no officially released Super 7 CPUs at 133 FSB. Now let's get back to the board. According to SpeedSys, this is a PC Chips MR586 LMR, but there are no such markings on the board itself. It's a small AT board with a ton of headers for VGA, audio, PS2, USB, and even LAN. Now let's take a closer look at the AGP port. Well, it's not actually an AGP port. According to the manual of a very similar board under the Matsonic brand that I found on the retroweb, this is an ADIMM slot. It seems to be some sort of proprietary slot for the SIS301 graphics core, adding analog TV out or output for LCD panels. It is physically an actual AGP slot, but moved a little bit to the left such that you cannot actually plug in an AGP card when the board is installed in case. Let's run some benchmarks. I'm using a K62 Plus CPU at 570 MHz, which is currently operating at 4x 100 MHz. But let's use the CPU speed tool to set it to 550 MHz so that I can directly compare the benchmark results with the ones I got from the SIS530 board from a previous video. We're getting a graphics card score of 1856 and a CPU score of 5150. For reference, the SIS530 board I had tested in a previous video was getting a score of 291 and 4095 respectively. The SIS540 score is better than even the Voodoo 3 score on the 530 board, which was at 1734 3D marks. And the funny thing is that these great results are with the RAM running at 100 MHz. Sadly, the BIOS does not have any options for selecting the RAM frequency. But here, at Scrap Computing headquarters, we don't give up so easily. I came across a great open source tool by Vogon's user Inail? Apologies if I butchered your name. The tool works with VIA chipsets and allows you to change the FSB, RAM, and PCI frequencies by directly configuring the motherboard's PLL chip via the I2C bus. After going through the implementation of that tool and understanding how it works, I decided to write my own for SIS chipsets, which I named SIS-FSB. Many thanks to the author of VIA-FSB for open sourcing the tool, it was a really great reference. When you first run SIS-FSB with no arguments, you get the list of supported PLLs, which is currently just one, the one on this specific board. Then, using -fsb list, prints the FSB, SDRAM, and PCI frequencies supported by the PLL. Let's try to set the RAM at 133. And the system hangs. Well, that was disappointing. Luckily, I have found a workaround. If we reduce the multiplier to a lower value with a tool like CPU SPD, then changing the RAM frequency won't crash the system. So let's set the multiplier to 3.5 and try again. And yeah, the system now uses the full 133MHz RAM speed. Let's set the multiplier back to 5.5 and let's rerun 3DMark. And yeah, we got a much better graphics score of 2164 up from 1856 and a better CPU score of 5738 up from 5150. That's a 17% and 12% improvement respectively. I did try setting both the FSB and RAM speed to 133MHz, but the system crashes right away when I do this. According to the VFSB tools documentation, this happens because the divider changes from 3 to 4. But I've had success loading the divider from 3 to 2 no problem, so I'm not sure what the issue is. Now let's try 3DMark 2000 at 100MHz SD RAM. We're getting a score of 639, which is way better than what the CIS530 got, which was a score of just 92. Now let's try the CPU SPD trick once again with a multiplier of 3.5 to try to set the DRAM speed to 133. But this time, the system hangs. After a reboot, let's try again with a multiplier of 3x. This time it works. Yeah, this workaround trick is pretty flaky. Let's run 3DMark once again. And we're getting a score of 816, a huge 28% improvement over the previous score. Okay, now let's try the Voodoo 3 2000 PCI, the same one I used in my CIS530 video. The first thing I notice is how much nicer and less noisy the image is. Okay, this one is with the RAM frequency at 100MHz. And we're getting a score of 1563, 15% lower than what we get with the CIS540. Now let's switch to 133MHz SD RAM and rerun the benchmark. And we're getting a score of 1840, which is still 15% lower than what we get with CIS540 at 133. While the system is running at 133MHz SD RAM, let's run 3DMark 2000. We're getting a score of 1002, which is 23% better than the CIS540 score. Now let's switch the system back to 100MHz and rerun the benchmark. And we're getting a score of 943, which is 48% better than what we got with the CIS540 at 100MHz, but just 16% better than CIS540 at 133. It clearly shows that the CIS301 graphics score in the CIS540 chip is a very powerful graphics score and is clearly limited by the memory bus, which is shared with the CPU. While the Voodoo 3 benefits from its higher clocked RAM, which is also not shared with the system. Now let's try some DOS benchmarks. Let's try SpeedSys at 100MHz SD RAM. We'll be right back. we're getting 95 megabytes per second memory throughput. Now let's do the multiplier trick to switch the memory to 133 MHz. And yeah, we're now getting memory throughput of 109 MB per second. Overall, I think that the CIS540 is an amazing chip for Socket 7. Its integrated graphics core is so powerful that it can compete directly with popular discrete graphics cards that were released just a few months earlier, like the Voodoo 3 2000, well, at least on weak CPUs like the K62 Plus 550. Oh, and by the way, there is no scrolling bug in Just Jackrabbit, which makes it one of the more compatible video chips too. Anyway, that's all for today. The SysFSB tool is open source and can be found on the project page on GitHub. I'm planning on adding support for more Sys chipsets and PLLs. If you have a Sys board you would like to get supported and can do some testing, feel free to open a ticket on the project's page. I hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, thanks for watching and goodbye.